why, the way they talk, you know, they've got more confidence on sickness, no, more confidence on failure, more confidence on all the things of the world except the word. Yeah. The Bible says we're put on Christ. You understand? He says, put on the whole armor of God. When you have confidence on what he bought for you on the cross, you are not going to talk your weakness. You talk his strength. He said, let the weak say I'm strong. You talk his might. You're not going to talk weakness. You know that I put on the armor of God. The Spirit of the Lord is working in me. He says, all things work together for my good. That's what you know. It's in your spirit. But if it's not there, it can come out. You struggle. The fellowship has to move forward in power and in manifestation of the results. You see, it says they're exposing the word. The word needs to be exposed from you, from us, from me. Amen. Amen. People have more confidence in other things. But the Bible says the breastplate of righteousness. Amen. Hallelujah. He says the shield of faith. That's what you're supposed to be confident in. What did God do? Do you know? You can't know if you don't go to the word. The word has to be eaten. It's not a choice of you whether you want or you don't. Because this is how you're going to live. This is how you're going to be saved. When you see somebody, you know, when you see people go back, they get it. You know what Jesus said in the book of Luke, chapter number 6? He says, he that heareth my sayings and doeth them. He says, I will liken you to whom he is like. He says, a man that is like a man that built a house where? On the rock, brother. He says, the storm came. The floods came. That house is rooted on the way, on the word. It's rooted, it's stuck on the way. It can't even be moved. You're fixed. You trust in the Lord. You know he's your strength. You know he's your source. Your word, his word is abiding in you. Amen. So the Bible says, they have no root in themselves. And they endure for a time. And then, you know, listen to what he says. He says, when affliction, he says, afterward, when affliction or persecution arises for the word's sake, oh God, their persecution and their affliction, they come to shake you because of the word. They're not coming because of you. No. Oh, because of, you know, the reputation of something. No, they're coming, the persecution, the devil stirs them up because of the word. He's trying to get you off. The way I told you, if you stay with the word, stay with faith, you will whip him all the time. So he knows that. So he's obligated to make sure that he shake you off from it, quick. But you have to have a root in themselves. The Bible says, if you continue in my word, he said, you shall know the truth. And he says, the truth will make you free. Ladies and gentlemen, it takes action on the word of God to set a man free. You can be born again, filled with the Holy Ghost. Wonderful. But you see, if you're not going to act on the word, sister, you can still stay bound. But you see, when you get in the word, you see, you know, the Bible says, walk in the spirit and you shall not fulfill the lust of the flesh. You don't even have to fight the things of the flesh. No, when you walk in the word and you are rooted, you know, the things of the devil, they will just fall off. They will quit you. Other than you quitting them, they will quit you. No. That's the power of the word. The word of God in your system. The word of God in my system. It has to be in my blood. It has to flow inside of me. I know when you know that, oh, you will never be the same. Let's go quicker. Now, he says, and these are they which are sown among thorns, such as hear the word and the curse of this world and the deceitfulness of riches and the lust of other things. Entering in, they choke the way. But now he says, and these are they which are sown on good ground, such as hear the word and receive it. And he says, and bring forth fruit. So when you hear it, you have to receive it. How do you know you receive the word? It's when it's in your heart. It bypasses your mind. You see, it's not enough, and it doesn't work. You just agree with the word by your mind, by your brain, your head. Yes, amen, yes, amen. No, it has to sink in. It has to sink in your system. He said they hear and they receive it. They receive it. You see, when a man is planning to kill somebody, he's going to murder in his heart. That's why, you know, in the courts, there will be, you know, we want to know whether this was what premeditated. He had it in his heart. So you have to put it and apply it in your word. The word of God has to be in your heart. Yeah. like when he's got murder in his heart, he's going to kill somebody. When you have the word in your heart, you're going to act on it. You're going to do what he says. You're going to do what he says. It's in you. Amen. Hallelujah. So the Bible says, then they produce fruit. Now, he says, as he could, he says, and he said unto them, is a candle brought to be put under a bushel? Okay, let me skip and go to verse 24. He says, and he said unto them, take heed what you hear. With what measure you meet, it shall be measured unto you. And unto you that hear shall more be given. If you are going to proceed, you see, there are things that the Lord could have told you, even years and times back. If you are going to receive more revelation, you see, what he has told you, go back to it. Act on it. If you have not measured it properly, more will not be added. He says, with what measure you meet, it shall be measured back to you. Amen.
Amen.
Now he says, for he that had, oh, listen to that. He that had to him shall be given, and he that had not from him shall be taken even that which he had. So a child, a man, woman, that are not going to act on the word. The Bible says even that which they thought they had is taken away from them. Hallelujah. So now I want you to see something again also here. For the earth, the Bible says, bringeth forth fruit of herself. First the blade, then the ear, after that the full corn in the ear. Amen. So what happened here? Now, when you feed on the word of God, the Bible says the earth, in other words, the ground produces. So when you put the seed in the ground, it dies, it germinates, it becomes the ground. He says the earth produces of itself. The same thing. When you eat the word of God, when you feed the word of God in your spirit, it becomes your spirit. Then produces a power called faith. And when you stand in front of that sickness, you say in the name of Jesus, go! The power that comes out like a tornado force and cast it out. It's in you. Amen. We are going to finish now. I'm going to show you something. Praise God. Hallelujah. When we start, after we got born again.
Amen.
Now we're gonna thank the Lord. It's the word that gives you strength. He is the portion of your strength. We start like this glass, you see? This glass is empty. You start with an empty glass. Now, when you feed on the word, you start every time, day in, day out, daily, little by little, you fill it into your spirit. Feeling in your spirit. Feeling in your spirit. You will come to the point where you hit the drop, right? And your cup runs over. Praise God. I'm going to drink some. Runs over, and then you come here, you say, you know, or maybe you are in the meeting, you say, oh, I think we should do that. It came out from your spirit. The light came up. You knew it. The Lord led you. Hallelujah.
Amen.
So, ladies and gentlemen, let's commit ourselves to the word. Let's live by the word. Let's live by the word. It's the word that's going to give us strength. Hallelujah. So, we're going to take our up to our feet. I want us to pray. We're going to make a commitment and tell the Lord, Lord, we need to eat your word. Praise God. We need success. Success in the fellowship. Progress. Results. Victory. Amen. So I would like that we pray. We're thanking God for the word. He reigns. He reigns. He's going to reign in your life. We're thanking God for this word. And we commit ourselves, the Lord. We're going to make time. We're going to make time. for you. Hallelujah. Hallelujah. And then after that, I'm going to ask Brother Mkhepe to come forward and he's going to take the mic. Let's pray and thank the Lord. Father, we give you the praise. Spirit of the Lord, we thank you. We give you the praise. We give you the praise. We give you the praise. Thank you for your word. Your word gives us strength. Your word works in us. Thank you. We commit ourselves to eating your word from tonight onwards. Show us how we ought to move. We give you the praise. We thank you, Lord, for what you've done. We thank you for the mercy. We thank you for the power that is in your way now. In the mighty name of Lord Jesus. Hallelujah. Lord.